Recently, I've read a lot about you
Oh.
before getting onto this call, and I see that you're an inspiration and actually an icon for people across globe when it comes to couraging and showcasing and standing for yourself and confidently coming out with your inner self. I would really like you to please take us through the journey till the landmark of being Anubhuti. I know people would love to know your story, and who do not know you would really be inspired after they hear about you. So over to you, Anubhuti. Please take us through your journey.
Thank you, Sugandha, for that wonderful introduction. I'm a little overwhelmed by the words that you used. I wouldn't put it so far as being an inspiration for around the globe for a lot of people, but at least what I found is that the more times I share my story, the things that I've done, it becomes a way which normalizes someone else's journey, which makes sure that someone else feels encouraged to be themselves at in their personal spaces as well as at work. So I think that's why I find sharing my story very sort of encouraging for myself as well. So for the people who do not know, let me start right at the beginning. I was born in a sort of a underdeveloped area in India, at the edge of a jungle at the border of Jharkhand and Orissa. And right then, one of the first things that I knew was that the gender that my parents and the people around me called me by was not correct. I knew that my gender was the same as of my elder sister, but it was for some reason that everyone had decided to call me, assign a male at birth. However, very soon, growing up, the first kindergarten play that I was part of, that was when I really faced the first shock of my life, because while I was okay with this realization all throughout my life, in the play, what happened is that I was chosen to play the king, and there was another role of the princess. And all the while that I was rehearsing for the play, all the while that I was practicing for it, all I could think of is that I wanted to play the role of the princess. I just wanted that. And that's the first thing that as a child, 5 years old, I knew is that this is what I wanted. Growing up from there, I went through a very, I would say a very difficult part of a few years in my teenage, which was when I faced something which is known by a lot of people as gender dysphoria, which is where you find your body growing into a gender that you do not accept and in a way that you do not want it at all. And that made things very, very difficult. It was a point of time when everyone was, really thinking about their future. Planning for the future, studying for it. I did not even know at that point of time if I had a future. But at least at that point of time, I heard this voice of God, which is also called television, in which I heard that there was something that it is possible for someone to transition to a gender that they are not born in. And I knew that this was my way to become a self-made woman. From that point of time, I knew that at that point of time, I cannot be that. There were some prerequisites that I needed to fulfill first. I needed to be independent in every which way I could understand. I needed to be socially independent, emotionally independent, and also financially independent. And I knew that this whole journey of me being a self-made woman, being accepted in the society as a woman, would need a lot of support from the society around me, but also something that I needed to do when I was independent on my own. And that is when I joined Tata Steel, I knew that that was the point that I joined Tata Steel from campus. I knew that that was the point when my dreams were supposed to be fulfilled. And I kind of expected the moment I joined that I kind of expected there to be a very large support group already for LGBTQ people, that the world would already know about people like me. I was a little surprised when I came into corporate India and found out that that was not the case. I found out that, there were a lot of, there were very few people talking about LGBTQ issues. And when I say LGBTQ issues, I mean about lesbian, gay, bisexual and transgender people, about sexual orientation and gender identity. There was very few people who were talking about it, and in hushed tones. And also people often would not take you seriously if you talked about these things. So from that point of time, I had to decide. I really faced the shock again. I had to decide what I had to do. But it is at that point of time that I started coming out at Tata Steel. I decided that, you know, this was a journey that I was going to take place, going to make in Tata Steel. And I also decided that this would be a journey in which I will take my workplace along with me, my organization along with me. And that is why I was very glad to have, you know, transitioned on the job. I became known as Anubhuti, which was really my story of realization, my story of growth. That is what is one of the most proudest thing that I can have said.
You know what, Anubhuti, when I was talking within my organization also, that, you know, we are having all these companies, you know, you don't realize that suddenly you become a face of something. And I was surprised to see, before I could tell my boss that what I'm actually going to talk about. So he said the moment he heard about Tata Steel diversity, and he clearly associated your face with it, because this is how he was actually reminded of that. Acha, I've heard her speaking. Is she Anubhuti? I said, yeah, she's the one from Tata Steel. So we don't realize with such small steps that we take, we actually become the flag bearers of that community from that organization. And I was really glad to see that, you know, your face has actually become when you associate the D&Y initiatives at Tata Steel. And which is very impressive, because we wouldn't see that in many other organizations. I've had a word with people from different organizations, all big companies, I would say, but then nowhere I could see that connect, that your face is actually now becoming a connect, or, you know, you're being associated with that subject. So I believe you also would be really glad to, you know, hear about it.
Absolutely, and that is a big responsibility. What I said is that my journey was very personal. It was, you know, rooted in my personal, you know, something I knew about myself, and it was something that I really wanted for myself. I did not expect that it would be such a big journey within the organization. But as I came to know of it, as I came to know of how big a change I was bringing about, that's when I realized that it was not only within my organization, but also being associated with a brand like Tata Steel, especially, it brought about such a large change within, outside the organization as well, within the whole ecosystem that we talk about as India Incorporated or the India Inc. What I realized is that the inclusive steps that Tata Steel took, the very pioneering initiatives that we took, for example, one of the things that we did for the first time in any manufacturing company is we started an employee resource group for LGBTQ people called WINGS. And that was something that we had done even before any other company in the Tata Group had managed it, including, you know, I got calls from Jaguar Land Rover telling that, you know, we have not yet come up with an employee resource group with LGBTQ people. And it is such a great thing to see the Tata Steel doing it. And to see Tata Steel do it meant that a lot of other companies who were, you know, very strongly within their closet, there were a lot of people working for LGBTQ inclusion, were doing a lot about D&I, but they needed that push from a large brand like Tata. You know, in India, we say a lot of things are legitimized when Tata does it. I think we legitimized it. We really brought it out a lot before a lot of people were talking about it. Because I'm talking about this in 2015-16 that we started this journey, made a lot of these changes. It was a whole different world back then. Section 377, which now is struck down from the law, it was very much in the law. There were people who were not talking about it. For that point of time, for a company like Tata Steel to come forward to make this, make this something that would be normalized, something that would be, institutionalized within the company for the next 100 years of its journey. That is the kind of commitment that Tata Steel took. And I think that is why we are seeing, that we've seen these wonderful effects in which, companies, organizations like yours have heard about the activities that I've done. It's of course lucky that I have been, the face of this journey, and I find that extremely emotional. I find that, when my picture was put in the Tata Experiential Center, it's the headquarters. In the headquarters, there is this sort of a museum, sort of an experiential center. They put up my story there. To have that in between pictures of J.R.D. Tata, the letter from Mahatma Gandhi for Tata's, in all these luminaries when that story was also featured, it really humbled me, changed me forever. And I think it really made me realize that, that I was in a right journey, and I'm happy that I did.
Plus, you're associated with a nice company also who are actually valuing your efforts and, giving you a platform like this or any other platform wherein you can actually talk about your story and inspire so many people. And, Amartya is also one of those employees, who has his own journey. Like Anubhuti. Amartya, I would really like you to tell people as to how supportive has the ecosystem and the people around you have been, in working a plant set up in the place where you are today. Plus, what challenges have you faced and how have you overcome?
Thank you so much for giving me opportunity. Actually, I joined Tata Steel in 2014. I'm basically from Howrah, and when I joined Tata Steel, that time I have no knowledge about Tata Steel support our LGBT community like that. But when I also confused about myself, about my sexuality. Okay. So that time utna himmat nahi tha. So when I got to know about this total टाटा स्टील उन लोग का फैसिलिटी के बारे में जब हमको पता चले, तो दैट टाइम हम फील की ओके. एंड मोस्टली इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग वॉज, अभी भी याद है, हम लोग का एक ग्रुप है, आई थिंक मोजाइक ग्रुप है. तो उसमें हम एक कमेंट किए थे, तो वो आफ्टर आई थिंक आफ्टर 5 to 6 मंथ्स अनुभूति कॉल्ड मी लाइक when Anubhuti called me like are you community matlab support ke liye ki tumko wahan pe koi problem ho raha hai ki nahi, like koi support kaise hai nahi hai wahan ka culture tumko koi, kyunki because plant culture and office culture is totally different.
Exactly.
Plant culture where in Jamshedpur, actually Jamshedpur is a small town, so hum jitna bhi abhi tak dekhe hai, jitna story sune hai, mostly they are from मेट्रो सिटीज, नॉट अ स्मॉल टाउन. सो हम कहीं ना कहीं थोड़ा डरे हुए थे कि इसमें अगर हम एक्सपोज करेंगे, खुद को एक्सप्रेस करेंगे, तो मे बी हमको कुछ बैड इफेक्ट आ सकता है. तो कभी हमको ऐसा सोचे ही नहीं थे. अनुभूति कॉल मी वन टाइम एंड ऑब्वियसली अमृता ऑल्सो कि इफ यू वॉन्ट देन वी कैन पब्लिश योर आर्टिकल. सो हम इसके पहले हमको थोड़ा बताना चाहता हूँ कि हम जब पहले हम इसके बारे में अपना एक कॉलिग्स को बोले, तो उन लोग को जब बोले, हम दो तीन जन जो मेरा बहुत क्लोज्ड है, तो उन लोग को जब बोले तो हमको ये लगा कि एक्चुअली मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल डोंट नो अबाउट आवर कम्युनिटी. दे नो रॉन्ग वे. आई मीन लाइक व्हेन आई से कि आई एम गे, so that time he said भैया ये कैसे है, मतलब आपका तो gesture वैसा feminine type का नहीं है, आपको क्यों, मतलब ऐसा type का कैसे है बोल रहे. तो हम बोले नहीं देखो ये ऐसा नहीं होता है कि जेस्टर फेमिनाइन होगा और ट्रांसजेंडर होगा, देनी मतलब सबका दिमाग में मोस्टली है कि ऑल आर मतलब हु आर लाइक फेमिनाइन जेस्टर्स एंड ट्रांसजेंडर आर ऑल आर मतलब इन एलजीबीटी कम्युनिटी अदर देन मतलब अदर्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल,
दैट्स एक्चुअली अ मिथ।
हां तो उस समय हम जब उन लोग को बोले तो उन लोग भी ये बात को समझे, आफ्टर दैट उन लोग इसको बारे में देखे भी, मतलब बहुत सारा गूगल में सर्च किए, बहुत सारा उन लोग स्टोरी पढ़े, तो उस टाइम पे उन लोग को पता चला ना इट्स वेरी नॉर्मल। एंड जब हमको अनुभूति एंड अमृता कॉल किए थे तब हम उन लोग को पहले पूछे कि हमको स्टेप फॉरवर्ड करना चाहिए कि नहीं चाहिए, तो उन लोग बोले भाई आपको करना चाहिए, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है। आई मतलब हम कभी सोचे नहीं थे इतना स्मॉल टाउन में इतना, मतलब हम जो एक्चुअली गलत सोच के रखे थे इतना दिन कि नहीं स्मॉल टाउन होगा कोई इस पर एक्सेप्ट नहीं करेगा, बहुत खराब इम्पैक्ट आ सकता है, बट टोटली आई वॉज रॉन्ग। जब ये आर्टिकल मेरा जो आर्टिकल वो पब्लिश हुआ, मुझे इतना मैसेज आया, इतना अप्रिसिएशन, पॉजिटिव मैसेज, हम कभी सोचे नहीं थे। तो उसमें कहीं ना कहीं बहुत ज्यादा मुझे वो पावर मिला। और उससे पहले भी एक बहुत अच्छा इंसिडेंट हुआ था मेरे साथ 2019 में, हम एक लड़के से मिले थे डेटिंग ऐप का थ्रू, तो उसके थ्रू हम गए फर्स्ट हम दिल्ली गए थे प्राइड वॉक, मेरा फर्स्ट 2019 प्राइड वॉक। तो वो प्राइड वॉक में जाके मेरा और भी मेरा मतलब क्या बोले मैं तो और भी कॉन्फिडेंस मिला, वो चीज़ अलग ही था क्योंकि मेरा पहला था और वो जो माहौल था वो बहुत ही एकदम यूनिक था। वहाँ पे भी हमको बहुत सारा कॉन्फिडेंस कॉन्फिडेंट होने का मतलब वो चार्मिंग वो चीज मिला। तो यहाँ पे जब हमको बहुत सारा जैसे आप पूछ रहे थे कि कैसे था यहाँ का जर्नी, तो ऐसा नहीं कि मोस्टली ऑल आर एक्सेप्टेड ऐसा कुछ नहीं था, कोई कोई था ऐसे भी, ये तो प्लांट कल्चर है तो जो भी ओल्ड आदमी लोग है उन लोग हमको कंटिन्यू पूछते रहता है कि थोड़ा सा अनईजी लगता था कि why you are not marrying, why you कब marry कर, मतलब कब शादी करोगे, यहाँ पे जो कल्चर है mostly कि तुमको जॉब हो गया तो अभी तो तुम्हारा शादी
हो गया। It's a stereotype, जैसे एक कम्युनिटी को एक्सेप्ट करने में मैं कहूंगी टाइम लगता है, वैसे एक माइंडसेट चेंज होने में भी टाइम लगेगा। एंड इट इज नॉट जस्ट विद यू, शायद मैं भी अगर वहां पर रह रही होती एंड इफ आई हैव अ जॉब, आई एम 25 यू नो, तो नाउ आई एम एक्सपेक्टेड टू गेट मैरिड, मे बी आई एम नॉट फाइनेंशियली स्टेबल, शायद मैं नहीं करना चाहती, बट एक वो माइंड सेट है।
बट एक लकीली हम लकी है कि मेरा जो डिपार्टमेंट है 90% है यंग पर्सन है, सो मतलब मेरा हिसाब से बहुत ईजी हुआ उन लोग को समझाना, क्योंकि एक जो इतना दिन से एक होता है ना कि इतना दिन से जो आदमी एक सोच लेके चल रहा है उनको कुछ बोलना और उनको एक्सेप्ट करेगा उससे अच्छा कि मतलब जो यंग पर्सन है उन लोग बहुत इजीली उस चीज को समझ सकते हैं। तो ये मेरा डिपार्टमेंट में बहुत इजीली हम हुआ जब ये पब्लिश हुआ। बहुत आदमी ऐसे भी पूछे हमको बाद में भी ऐसा पूछे कि व्हाई यू आर नॉट ट्राइंग विद अ गर्ल, आई एम बोला सीरियसली, मतलब एक दो जन ऐसा पूछे थे, तो हम उन लोग को बहुत अच्छे रिप्लाई दिए थे कि देखो ठीक है हमको कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, बट एक चीज तुम सोचो कि हम अगर कोई गर्ल के साथ तुम्हारे हिसाब से अगर ट्राई करेंगे, तो अगर वो गर्ल तुम्हारा सिस्टर बा तुम्हारा कोई रिलेटिव हो तुमको बाद में पता चलेगा तुम्हारा क्या रिएक्शन होगा। तो वो बोले कि हाँ, बोला कि नहीं 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 ये तो सीरियसली पॉसिबल नहीं, बोला सेम टू सेम, क्योंकि ये कोई ट्राई का चीज नहीं है कि हम हाँ हम कि मेरा मतलब इसमें हमको मेरा वो स्टीरियोटाइप्स मतलब जाना ही है हमको, कोई ऐसा कुछ नहीं है। इवन अभी भी बहुत जन बोलता है कि तुम क्यों पार्टनर क्यों नहीं ढूंढ रहे, तो हम उन लोग को वही बोलते हैं कि हाँ ऑब्वियसली पार्टनर अगर मिलेगा तो बहुत अच्छा चीज है, नहीं मिलेगा भी हम आगे कैसे बढ़ेंगे, वो मेरा मतलब मेंटल स्टेबिलिटी हो गया, मतलब वो हम उतना सोच लिए। तो जो भी है, तो उसके बाद जब ये पब्लिश हुआ उसके बाद हम मम्मी पापा को पहला बार बोले थे कि मेरे बारे में ऐसा, तो उन लोग ऑब्वियसली शॉक्ड हो गए थे कि मम्मी का नॉर्मली मतलब क्या बोल रहे हो, मतलब मोस्टली क्या प्रॉब्लम है कि हम सिंगल चाइल्ड है, तो और भी थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम था कि क्या तुमको कौन देखेगा, जनरेशन कैसे आगे बढ़ेगा, हम फैमिली में क्या बोलेंगे, मतलब रिलेटिव्स को क्या बोलेंगे। तो धीरे 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 शायद उन लोग थोड़ा थोड़ा समझ रहे हैं हम ये बारे में, और कभी हमको वो टॉपिक में कभी आज तक हमको और उसके बाद बोलेंगे बोले कुछ नहीं, बट हमको कभी कुछ प्रेशराइज कुछ नहीं किया कि शादी करना है ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, बट आई एम नाउ फ्री कि आई एम ऑलरेडी मतलब अपने तरफ से सब कुछ बोल दिया। इन उन लोग का भी हाँ ऑब्वियसली टाइम लगता है, ऐसा नहीं है कि बहुत इजीली ये सब एक्सेप्टेड हो जाता है, और मेरा इस हिसाब से मेरा सीनियर लोग भी जहाँ पे मतलब मेरा डिपार्टमेंट में है उन लोग भी बहुत सपोर्टिव है, तो हम कभी सोचे नहीं थे कि इतना मतलब स्मॉल टाउन में इतना अच्छा, इतना मुझे प्यार मिला इन द सेंस कि ऐसा नहीं कि मुझे कोई अलग से अलग कुछ ट्रीट किया जाता है, पहले भी नहीं अभी भी नहीं। और सबसे अच्छा लगता है कि उन लोग कभी भी मतलब ये जानने के बाद भी आज तक हमको नहीं लगा हम लोग का रिलेशन मतलब आवर कॉलीग्स रिलेशन कभी ऐसा कुछ भी चेंज हुआ, पहले जैसे थे उन लोग को जानने के बाद भी ऐसे ही है, मतलब हमको वो चीज कभी फेस नहीं करना पड़े कि बहुत बहुत दिक्कत है बात बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, ये भाई लकी
है। इसमें ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस का रोल तो होता ही है बट एक पर्सनल फाइट भी होता है इंडीड, एंड सबसे फर्स्ट फाइट वो होता है वो फैमिली के साथ, नॉट अ फाइट आई वुड से, बट देन शायद हम आज के टाइम में कलीग्स के आगे एक्सेप्ट कर सकते हैं, बट इट टेक्स लिटरली करेज टू गो एंड एक्सेप्ट द सेम विद इन योर फैमिली। पीपल आर रियली आई हैव सीन वेरी वोकल अबाउट देयर सेक्सुअलिटी व्हेन इट कम्स टू यू नो टॉकिंग विद इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, बट वो इतने ओपन अभी नहीं है व्हेन इट कम्स टू यू नो टॉकिंग एट होम, बट यू केम आउट वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट और मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा ये चीज सुन के। नाउ अनुभूति विद यू ऑल्सो फ्रॉम एन एम्प्लॉयज पर्सपेक्टिव आई बिलीव दैट यू टू मस्ट हैव गॉन थ्रू इन्यूमरेबल रफ रोड्स टू रीच वेयर यू आर टुडे। How did you gauge the courage to fight all such stigmas? You know, please let us know. And how has Tata Steel proven to be a constant pillar of support for you?
I mean, listening to Amartya's story and his, the way he expressed it, that kind of reminded me of how my journey also was. You know, it had both of these things. It had a lot of victories, a lot of rewards. But it also had a lot of challenges. It was especially difficult for me at a point of time because I think I was talking about this in around 2015-2016 when the social perception was a little way behind even what it is right now. So when I was coming out, when I was saying it to a lot of people, while everyone did absolutely respect someone's decisions, someone's, whatever they're saying, there were still ways in which I found, a little uncomfortable in certain situations. And I think this is especially true because I was making the very large jump from, being perceived as a certain gender to being perceived as a completely different gender. We know that in society already, when I first started being seen as a woman, going out as a woman, experiencing the whole society as a woman, I was shocked, the kind of restrictions of freedom, the kind of restrictions of personal decision and personal, choice that were not afforded to women by default, by nothing to do with being part of the LGBTQ community or not. So that by itself was, a sort of a time when I kind of woke up that, okay, we are really not we are really not giving people the amount of freedom that they should, that there is no particular stereotypes that we should hold on to for a certain gender and not hold on to the other gender. And these were very, very difficult for me to go through at that point of time. However, at that point of time, when I was, initially going through my journey, a lot of my well-wishers, a lot of my friends, they used to tell me that, it is better you don't do it. It is better you don't do it in India. Because this is a perception that you can't do anything in India. So they used to say, don't do it here. Don't do it in a small town. Don't do it in a, here. But I realized that, no, I do want to do it here. I want to be where I am, and I want the world to change. I want the world to change around me. I want my workplace to change. I want the society around me to change. And to some extent, like Amartya said, I also wanted my family to, love and accept me as I am.
Exactly.
So in that journey, a very large part was, of course, played by the workplace, by Tata Steel, in which I know that I came out at workplace long before I came out to my parents. It's that much. Nowadays, we, as in, you know, that we spend a huge amount of time at our workplace. It is akin to saying that our family, our workplace is our second family, if you can say. So at that point of time, the kind of support that I found in my workplace, the kind of support, the moment I had come out to our chief diversity officer, who is now vice president of human resources, I came out to her. I moved all the way, I took a trip from Jamshedpur to Calcutta to meet her and to tell her about it. The moment I told her about it, the first thing she said is that you are going to get all the amount of support that you would need. And you can feel completely free of to do this in the organization. To do this meaning that, you know, to transition and to be yourself in the organization. And that was extremely important, because it is known that there will be challenges, because whenever we are doing something pioneering, whenever we are doing something that has not been done before, there are bound to be challenges. But exactly. The support that was committed, that was said, that was very, very important in me, you know, disregarding the fears that I had talked about, you know, the fears that my friends had, that my well-wishers had. So that fear, those fears were disregarded. I knew that, you know, I had the kernel of strength in myself. And I knew that I have a support, you know, support system at my workplace. I have a support system who's going to support me. And the issues that, you know, a lot of people face, that, you know, the social support that they would get, the financial independence that they require, that is something that the workplace can provide. And so these things were extremely essential for me, being able to realize this dream, being able to, you know, dive headlong into it and not worry about how it's going to end, because I knew that it was going to end, you know, in the direction that I wanted. But of course, it has been, the reception has been completely over, you know, any expectations that I had. It has been completely different, and I feel, you know, it has given a very long part of my life. It has given a very large purpose, which I think all of us want, that, you know, our lives should have purpose. So I think that part is also, you know, very important, that doing this at Tata Steel and Tata Steel supporting me has given my life, or at least that part of my life, a very big purpose.
Well, I'm really glad to hear that organizations playing such a big role in this. Anubhuti, your choice of being associated as a woman, you know, must have drawn holes in your pocket, because the surgeries do cost a lot. You know, how has your company, when you said that you went and explained what you want to go through and they said that you'll have full support from Tata Steel, how did your company and staff help you achieve your end goal?
Yeah, that is absolutely true. As in, a lot of trans women want to go through, you know, a lot of different surgeries so that, you know, so that their body matches the image that they have in their head. And that is, of course, something that is a very essential thing for a lot of trans people, to be themselves, to be happy people. And that is something that I had, you know, I had in mind, and it is something that I had dreamed about and thought about a lot. But then, as you mentioned, it was always going to be a big challenge financially for me to be able to do this. So it is at that point of time when I did discuss about, and I also cited a lot of examples externally, say outside India or somewhere, where a lot of organizations support, you know, at that point of time there were no other Indian organizations who had a lot of, you know, had a policy for supporting what is called a sexual affirmation surgery, or, you know, something like that. So I told them that, you know, there are a lot of international organizations, there is a lot of literature on this, and it is something that I will definitely need. And that is something that the company decided that, yes, this is something that is inherently essential. It is an essential intervention, essential medical intervention for anyone who's going to transition or who wants to transition. It is going to be essential. So that's why they brought about, you know, at that point of time, it was brought about for me. And then later on, it was brought about as part of policy, in which Tata Steel covers to a very large extent the medical expenses that someone would incur